Tel que promis, on a le plaisir d'accueillir cet après-midi deux des membres de la formation torontoise Slash Puppet qui seront en spectacle demain samedi au Backstreet à Montréal, où pas plus tard que hier, Aldo Nova était là. Il y a plusieurs gens qui ont participé d'ailleurs à une série de spectacles qui se déroule là-bas et ça devient de plus en plus achalandé. On a le plaisir de recevoir Miff.
Pleased to meet you once again. We're doing it like the repeat performance. Pete, welcome to Music Plus.
Thanks.
I've heard your material this week, as a matter of fact, as I was telling you a couple of minutes ago, and I was kind of flabbergasted to hear this kind of material coming out of Toronto, actually, because the Toronto scene these days is kind of different, and you guys can offer something that I think the Canadian public needs right now.
How did
this come around?
I think it was a situation basically where Pete and myself have been in bands, in and out of bands, where, you know, we were doing cover tunes and going out and playing AC/DC and Judas Priest and Iron Maiden, all the wonderful bands that we grew up listening to, you know. Van Halen, can't not mention Van Halen, it's a particular favorite of mine. But anyways, we got fed up doing it, and basically we felt that ourselves, as well as you know, other members and other bands that were doing it, were creating a stagnation in Toronto that that was going to be very hard to dig yourself out of in a situation where, you know, 2 years ago, if you went to any club in Toronto, bar none, you would probably go in and look at a ZZ Top tribute in one club, a Rolling Stones tribute in another club. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Now, there's nothing wrong with doing that. I mean, if people feel it's viable for them to do that, by all means.
It's a business.
It is a business. Yeah. You know, there are some people out there who look at it just as business, but for the love of music. And, you know, basically we decided, personally for myself, I can't speak for Pete, but for myself, I didn't feel, first of all, that I had the vocal quality to do justice to some of these artists. And, you know, I figured if I'm going to do it for myself, if I'm going to be successful with it, then I have to, you know, harness my own talent and eventually develop it to the point where I can do
it for myself,
and I'm hoping that we're doing that now.
Tell me, did you start including kind of your own material in sets when you were already performing the bar scene and so on and so forth, or you just decided to cut that at one point?
We started from day one.
Stop the cover and do original stuff right off the bat.
With the exception of one or two songs.
Well, we started day one writing our own creative. Yeah. Like, we wanted to be creative. I'm doing cover songs, you can't be creative too much. So we started from day one writing our own songs, and once in a while we'll slip in an old classic, you know, for an encore, or if we, you know, feel like, you know, let's do this for our fans. And but basically, no, we started day one doing our own tunes.
Yeah, every member in the band was fed up with doing.
And fans, you have a lot of in Toronto. I've heard that all your shows are almost sold out. And,
yeah.
You sold 2,000 copies and more of a demo tape.
Yes, yes.
Which is quite unseen in this neck of the woods. I don't know, but
unseen in the sense that it's a heavier band.
Yeah.
I would agree with you. There's a lot of good talent coming out of Toronto. You know, I feel it's more of a transitional rebellion that's going on with the harder stuff in Toronto. The music industry hasn't been kind to heavy metal / hard rock in the Toronto region, right across Canada. It's very hard. You know, they've been unfair as far as promoting bands or
same thing in this province, as a matter of fact.
Yeah,
look at,
you know,
bands,
I mean,
like,
and I include Quebec as,
just,
you know,
about, you know,
as a part of Canada, and yeah, it's unfortunate that happens, but. We're headstrong and we've gone through it, and hopefully we're a part of something that's changing. You know, there's been some artists that have gone down to the United States that have done quite well, and hopefully, you know, we'll be in line to do that too.
Now, what's happening this weekend? Is this some kind of a showcase or something to just meet the public in Montreal? Or?
No, we are up here legitimately to play for the people of Montreal. Okay. We've had a lot of mail coming across our tables from right across Canada and North America, and a lot of it comes out, you know, comes from Quebec, Laval, Montreal being two of the more popular spots. And it was just a situation where, you know, Montreal was after us for a while. Backstreet had been chasing us to do the show, and we finally got it together, and with the help of SRO management, and we're finally up here now. We're looking forward to playing for Montreal.
All right. Tell you what, we're going to watch the first video. I'm going to talk to the French audience.
Go ahead, by all means.
Selon Miff et Pete, c'est quand même assez difficile de percer dans le monde du hard rock et, bon, entre guillemets, le métal au Canada, surtout dans la région torontoise où pendant un certain temps, il y a quelques années, alors qu'eux ont commencé, c'était vraiment pas évident, comme on dirait au Québec, parce qu'à chaque bar où vous alliez retrouver soit quelqu'un qui jouait du matériel de ZZ Top ou qui personnifiaient les Rolling Stones ou qui faisaient carrément pas leur propre matériel. Cependant, eux l'ont fait pendant un bout de temps, jusqu'à un certain point où Miff s'est dit, bon, ben là, ça suffit, j'en ai soupé de faire le matériel des autres, d'autant plus qu'il croyait que sa voix ne représentait pas très bien ou ne faisait pas honneur, ni plus ni moins, aux artistes qui tentaient carrément de personnifier ou pas d'imiter, mais quand même d'interpréter leur matériel, du matériel comme Judas Priest, AC/DC et plusieurs autres. Donc, à un certain point, il s'est dit, ben pourquoi pas tenter de mettre le contrôle sur notre propre matériel et de contrôler notre propre talent et justement de poursuivre une propre carrière et de trouver justement une identité propre à eux. C'est ce qu'ils ont fait et d'ailleurs à Montréal en fin de semaine, c'est la première fois qu'on les verra parce qu'ils ont reçu beaucoup de courriers du Québec. Ils sont en demande depuis un bon bout de temps, mais c'est en fin de semaine qu'on aura l'occasion de les voir pour la première fois. On va regarder un clip d'ailleurs de Slash Puppet qui s'appelle Slow Down. On est de retour avec Miff et Pete dans quelques instants, Musique Plus. Slash Puppet à Musique Plus, vous aurez l'occasion de les revoir d'ailleurs à Solid Rock très bientôt. En fin de semaine au Backstreet à Montréal, à Angle Mayer, c'est tout près de Musique Plus d'ailleurs, où il y a d'excellents spectacles qui sont présentés. I'm looking at the video and I see Anthem, Sony Music.
Yeah.
Do we have some kind of major deal here?
There are no details, however. It's a situation. It is a situation.
You've been sworn to secrecy, eh?
No, it's not. It's just a situation where no matter what happens, I believe that the product will be released in Canada, throughout Canada, under Anthem, under the Anthem label, which is in turn distributed by Sony CBS. Yeah. So that's just something that's going to happen. Right now what we're trying to do is get some interest down in the United States and across the world. And basically, you know, we've had some showcases, some record labels come up and see the band, and we're just going through the motions of finding that one person who's going to say, yeah,
you
I
must
like
have
these
enough
guys.
Material for an album already.
Yeah, we're okay. Forever writing.
Yeah, we have enough material. Some of the material, especially off this demo tape that song is off you just saw, is close to 2.5 years old. So since then, our writing's matured, and we have just a countless number of songs already to do an album. It's just a matter of getting in there and start recording.
What about production? Do you do your own production work?
This particular track that you heard was produced by ourselves and a gentleman by the name of Archie Hatch. He runs a studio down in Brampton, Ontario.
And there must be a few people going, okay, I wouldn't mind working on this project.
It has happened. Yeah. Well, on this particular project, you mean?
Well, the one that's going to happen, because obviously you're going to record something soon.
If that's happening, quite secret to us. we're not being told very much with what, with the business details. We're busy doing what we have to do from an artistic standpoint to get our stuff prepared.
Well, that's good, you know, because if you try to take care of everything yourself, I think you kind of jeopardize your creativity up to
all the more reason why it's such a great thing that we got signed to SRO Management, which has basically alleviated some of the materialistic business BS that we've had to deal with. You know?
All right. Pour la formation, il y a quelque chose qui s'en vient, évidemment, parce que ce que vous avez vu tantôt, ça date de 2 ans déjà, mais ils ont beaucoup, beaucoup de matériel à offrir. Ils s'attendent d'ailleurs d'un jour à l'autre, sinon d'une semaine à l'autre, de se faire offrir quelque chose de très sérieux au niveau des compagnies de disques, parce qu'il y en a déjà qui sont intéressés. Il y a déjà des réalisateurs qui sont intéressés. J'ai l'impression que ce n'est pas la dernière fois que vous allez voir les Slash Puppet ici à Musique Plus, non plus à Montréal. On va les voir probablement plus souvent bientôt, et il y aura d'autres vidéoclips à venir bientôt également. Ce qu'on vous invite à faire, c'est d'aller voir le groupe live, parce que j'ai l'impression que c'est là que vous allez capter vraiment l'énergie et l'atmosphère que ces gens-là peuvent dégager. C'est au Backstreet en fin de semaine. Miff, thanks a lot for coming
in.
It's
been a pleasure.
And you're always welcome here.
Thank
Pete
very,
as well.
Very much.
Come by when you have something else to let us know, and we'll be glad to have you.
See everybody at Backstreet tomorrow night.
That's right. All Backstreet demain soir. On poursuit nous avec Temple of the Dog et Hunger Strikes à Musique Plus, Cap Levin.